didn't miss much.
Anthony is fucking phenomenal.
Hopefully he's got good people around him.
Hunter's bombed his brethren.
He has to look after himself.
Go, go.
You know, just media can't be.
Alex Hunter, I really am wasting time.
Will Alex Hunter stay or go?
Hey, Neon Saxon, welcome.
What does your heart tell you?
If I stay, it will be trouble.
Hi, I'm a dude.
What up, guys?
I'm here.
All right, we had a little hiccup. My name is
Jesse Wellens. And do we know what happened?
It's just my internet.
I'm here to talk about Need for Speed. So Jesse Wellens. Payback. All right, here we go. Need for Speed.
If you guys didn't know Need for Speed Payback, yeah, it's a great game.
Here we go.
But all right. All set aside, I'm a YouTube creator, Need for Speed Payback, it's coming out. I got my boy Marcus, executive producer here. He is the producer of the game. Thank you, Nick.
I don't like this guy already.
Hey, man. Yeah, thanks, Jesse.
A little bit of a stumble there at the gate.
Obviously, we're excited to tell everyone about Need for Speed Payback
this guy
today, but more importantly, show it.
Yes.
In Payback, you are on a revenge mission.
This guy's got the hairdo, the glasses, and
how
the jacket that says
hotel that rules the city's casinos, criminals,
this
and cops, and
this
that
guy looks
is
like
delivering,
he's out
we're delivering
revenge.
A brand new experience
like
with wild heist missions, intense car pursuits, grueling car battles, and jaw-dropping action moments. No longer is this just being about being first across the finish line. We are putting you behind the wheel of an action-driving fantasy.
So Need for Speed has been around for a long time.
Are we back up
There's
live?
There's been a lot of new things coming to the game.
Yeah, I thought so.
And a lot of old things that people are familiar with the franchise.
Exactly. You know, we're putting a new narrative into the game where you drive three different characters, Tyler, Jess, and Mac, all bringing their own unique play style to the game. You drive across city, mountains, deserts, and canyons in the most diverse open world ever made for a Need for Speed game. There's
gorgeous.
A lot of great new elements in this game, but also obviously a lot of fundamentals like customization. We go way deeper when it comes to visual and performance
cool.
customizations, as well as introducing
right
something
that.
On top of that, something we call derelicts, which are abandoned classic cars that you transform from scrap to stock to supercars.
Speaking of customization, my homie Nick.
So it's Forza's Barnes.
It looks like he's customizing
exactly.
a classic
He
Beetle.
Stole my facial hair.
He's going to be doing a lot more of this customization and gameplay at 1:30 on the stream if you want to come back. But enough talking about it. I'm trying to see it.
Yeah, we're absolutely
I don't really care for this guy.
First, one of the blockbusters from Need for Speed Payback called the Highway Heist that shows
I
that intense
the guy,
action
the
driving
men in Blazers
experience.
Better than this guy.
So let's turn around and take a look.
Well, they had Blazers.
Well, yeah.
All right, here we go.
Here we
go.
In motion.
Need for Speed.
Koenigsegg Regera. 0-60 in 2.7 seconds.
Okay.
We intercept, then grab the cargo.
It'll be part of a convoy.
What are you thinking?
Quick hit and run. Get me close to the truck, and I'll take care of the rest.
We're in the daylight now, gang.
Before it hits the tunnel.
Like, all of the last Need for Speed was at night.
Is at night, yep.
This looks real.
Get rid of these guys.
Looks very nice.
Yeah. Ooh!
That's a burnout style crash right there.
Ooh.
Yes, 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 that is.
You have my attention, game.
Yes, you do. So this reminds me of Fast and the Furious Hardcore so far.
Well, I'm sure that's what they're going for.
Oh, I'm sure.
What the hell?
This guy's out of his mind.
There's something much bigger going on here.
What's the play?
Forget the tunnel. We get him before he reaches the city.
Voice acting's terrible. Forget the tunnel. Like,
guys,
you'd be in a more...
That's not a finished project.
Yeah.
Wow, well, right. It doesn't. It looks
I
great.
I'm so fascinated by lighting in games these days. Oh, man.
I enjoy these burnout crashes immensely.
It's always a Mustang.
Yeah, these are cool.
What they are?
They're going down.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yo, yeah.
Ooh.
Oh, wow.
Which is dead.
That's cool.
You gotta see it. You gotta see it more, like, dramatically, though.
Take him out, Ty.
Mustang. It's always a Mustang, isn't it?
Guys, Cindy's coming up fast. Jess, I've got a really bad idea.
What was that? What was that?
Ladder on the
voice.
Side. You can get up on his right.
I've got a really bad idea.
No, never, Jess. Do it.
The voice
so this is, yeah.
$1.9 million for the car trying to steal, apparently.
Well, right.
Ah, this is why they're not using live actors. Can't
right.
do this shit. Oh, come on.
Yeah, this is Fast and Furious.
Jess? You got this?
Jess?
Okay,
yes!
I'm on board. This is dumb. I like it.
Yeah.
This is stupid, but it's so cool.
Yes, it is like the exact kind of stupid that you want.
She can do.
And
this
you
is
see
like
the frame
took...
rate increasing, so you're getting that sense of speed.
Yeah.
With the faster car.
Okay,
yep.
Boys, let's even the odds.
Oh, here we go. The authorities are here.
I am on board. Yeah. I am on board.
Yeah, that's
on
cool.
board. That was cool.
I can assure you that
trailer
plays
looked real.
As well as
trailer
looks.
Looked really nice.
Last year at EA Play, we unveiled EA Originals.
When that card came out of
the
trailer, that
was
fantastic.
We created to support small independent studios.
Here we go.
Shall bring experiences that are unique,
Unravel
gorgeous,
two.
Innovative,
Unravel
and memorable to
we
the world.
We forgot they exist. No,
we
remember that they're
real
people.
With game creators through the process
the
from
real
development to
that
marketing
we like
to
crush.
Publishing. But
do we see that fee or fey game? Do we think we see it here?
Nah, Unravel 2.
The profits from these games.
Yeah, I think Unravel 2 is coming. I agree.
We have been overwhelmed with the.
So do we just forget about fee or fey?
I can tell you, we've received hundreds of pitches. Many of them brilliant, and as a result, we now have several new titles in development.
And many of them so
today,
stupid.
I want to introduce you to our next EA Originals title. One that I've been very close to from the beginning.
It's called Battlefield.
This game tells a story in an entirely new way. Now, a few years ago, I played the indie hit, Brothers, A Tale of Two Sons, with my oldest daughter. I loved how different the game felt.
It's this studio.
The mechanics and storytelling were really cool, and we both loved the emotional story. So I decided to contact the game's creator, Joseph Farris. When we met, we instantly realized we had the same passion for games and how to bring new experiences to players. I also found out that he was building a new studio called Hateslight. Now, we're thrilled to be working with Joseph to bring his new project.
Is it Hateslight?
What started out as a wild idea on paper has now turned into a
groundbreaking,
one-of-a-kind game called A Way Out. Take a look.
A Way Out.
What's
the
your
Peter
plan?
Moore story.
Stay the hell away from me, okay?
I'm intrigued. A little bit intrigued. So is this Prison Break the game?
That already exists.
Well, yeah.
I'm sure you have good reasons to bust out of here, but I need to get out of here too.
Yeah? Not my problem.
Well, you can trace. Elvis doesn't
now.
Care.
Oh, what? That is very cool.
It's pitch black. We need a light.
Screw it. I'll go first.
Oh, crap!
You okay?
Oh, wow, that's a cool.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Oh.
This seems Army of Two.
Well, it, I was getting an Army of Two vibe.
I love you, buddy.
That's it. What are you doing here?
She's my daughter, too. See? Problem solved.
Come on, Leo!
Now we're Uncharted.
Yeah. That's for Doc
Sold.
Ruckus. That's A Way Out from the studio who made Brothers.
Sold.
So Hazelights?
Hey,
Hazelight.
My name is Joseph Farris, and I'm the writer-director of A Way Out. I'm so excited to be here and show you the game. So, after I finished Brothers, I wanted to make another game that pushed the boundaries on how to tell stories without compromising on gameplay. And this is the reason
So I wrote down Prison Break, Uncharted, and Army of Two. Those are the three games I got vibes from there.
Originals was perfect for this because we have the full creative freedom and trust from EA to deliver the game we truly believe in. And that is very important for his life, let me tell you that.
Gameplay will be DLC.
The idea for A Way Out came to me when me and a friend trying to find a co-op game that wasn't just a drop-in, drop-out experience. I wanted to play a game where the characters had unique personalities and goals. A game where me and a friend can embark on an emotional journey together. And this is exactly what A Way Out is. The game is designed for split-screen co-op only, and I mean only. So you will be able to play it online, but to get the full experience and feel, we want you and your friend to play it in your couch.
Put a big question mark on that.
Gameplay-wise...
So...
Yeah, couch tonight, right?
Actually, is it multiplayer only?
Finally, yeah. And what was I going to say? Yeah, let me tell you. Okay, wait, it's coming to me. Come on. Gameplay-wise, it's going to be crazy. There's going to be a huge amount of variation. You're going to be able to play everything. I mean, not everything, but a lot of stuff. There's going to be exploration, driving, action. So you
I
get
feel like he's talking in circles here.
So, but let me tell you this. After you finish playing A Way Out, I will tell you, you will play a co-op game like never before. I know, I mean, I can guarantee that. I know I sound very cocky, but I can't help it because it's true. I'm so pumped up, it's crazy. You don't know, I live, breathe this game.
He's a genuine person.
It's like, yeah. It's gonna kick ass, it's gonna kick ass. So right now, I will show you a gameplay video.
Hey, okay.
I'll show you just a small part of the game, but still, you're gonna get blown away. And I also want to say that I'm so proud and happy to be part of this industry. It's crazy how fun it is to be here and do these games. It's so much fun.
Let's just play off music. Let's go.
And also, one last thing. I want to say hello to my Hazelight team watching live from Sweden. Thank you. Goodbye. Hop shaky. Boom. Come on.
Hop rump shaker boom. Is Rikishi coming out?
A Way Out is a story-driven co-op game. It is designed, played, and experienced only in split-screen co-op.
That sucks.
Which means you have to play the game with a friend, either online or on your couch.
So there's no single player, is what I'm getting.
You play as Vincent and Leo. You and a friend will get to know your characters and unfold their story together.
You don't know anything about me, man.
Maybe not. But Harvey killed someone very close to me. With or without you, I'm going after him.
Let me show you some of the scenarios in the game. On the right side, you see Leo, who's already in prison. On the left, you see Vincent, who just arrived. Now, if you look to the right again, you can see that Leo can be controlled while Vincent is in a cutscene. Here is another one. Vincent and Leo are now in the laundry room. The goal is to smuggle sheets using a laundry cart. You can approach the scenario in different ways. Either get the cart with Vincent.
No, I got a good pack right here. I think it's got your name on it. It's broken. I don't know.
Or with Leo.
Get over here.
The concept seems cool.
Yeah, but I think those two guys are just about to fight.
The concept is very cool, but
what was him?
And it seems really, really fun.
You will experience something new all the time. Everything
if I don't have someone to play with me.
That scene. We want you and your friend to be focused and engaged throughout the entire story. But let me tell you, this is just the beginning of what you will be experiencing in A Way Out.
It looks gorgeous.
Yeah.
It looks fantastic. Kudos to EA, because everything they're showing right now has looked fantastic.
A element of Mirror's Edge almost.
Yep.
I don't know. I'm hyped for this one.
Relax, man. I got this.
Yeah, we've got some mixed reaction there in the chat. So
I'm hyped and bummed at the same time.
Early 2018.
Okay. I'm going to write that down.
I know. Me again.
I'm hyped because it looks fantastic,
thank you, Joseph,
but I'm
that
bummed
game
because
is absolutely stunning, and I can't wait for
what if you guys are busy and I have no one to play with?
Now let's switch gears for just a minute. It's great
friends.
To be here showing you the games you'll play this year.
But you guys are
but
my friends.
At the same time, we are inspired to look farther ahead. Creative ideas combined with new technologies become
granted, you'll be able to play it online, so that
we
makes sense.
We have teams today taking technologies that are changing the world and using them to change the way we play. These are the futurists, the incubators, our talented artists, designers, and engineers within our studios, our Frostbite team, our digital platform.
Everybody's saying, oh,
and a new research division called C.
Saying they're going to go clone themselves.
What motivates me every day is the responsibility we have to push our industry forward. That's one reason we created this new division. Seed is a small, stealthy team that I work with on a daily basis. Exploring some of our most
visionary concepts. We had Ben Kenobi, 83. Thank you for jumping into the chat. Also says, can't wait for this to be free on Xbox mid-2018.
As you wish. Or virtual humans with deeply sophisticated artificial intelligence. So instead of one main character shared by millions, we can have millions of main characters shaped by you. That's just the beginning of how we can blur reality and the digital world. Go anywhere, share your discoveries, be anyone. The games become yours. Now, what we know today is that interactive entertainment will change more in the next 5 years than it has in the last 45. Together, we are building that future, one that disrupts, empowers, and is full of play. And to do that, we also need innovative new platform technology. So when we were thrilled when we got our first project Scorpio dev kits from Microsoft.
Uh-oh.
6 teraflops and true 4K.
Uh-oh.
The first thing he says, teraflops.
Now, these Madden NFL 18 visuals are just a taste of what can be accomplished combining Frostbite with Project Scorpio.
Uh-oh.
And already, we are creating the most detailed, high-resolution.
You know, everything's going to be on a PS4 Pro or Scorpio this weekend.
Yeah. Madden looks absolutely stunning. But as game makers, awesome graphics and effects are just the beginning.
I gotta see
the game has to feel amazing as well. Project Scorpio.
Yeah, show
is
me last year's
platform,
game on like an Xbox One
right
S.
Time. Now, I have one more thing before I go. New IP is one of the purest forms of innovation in our industry. A brand new idea combined
with
the
latest
tech
Kenobi,
and a vision for something extraordinary. The next game will push every boundary for you. It
for
is
me?
Vast, dangerous, beautiful, and unexpected.
It's my Tinder profile.
So this is just the first tease that we're showing you today. Then we will have so much more in the Microsoft press conference tomorrow. So don't miss that.
Tease? Uh-oh.
But for now, here's the first clip.
EA is going to show
brand
more tomorrow.
New IP from BioWare.
Here we go. Here we go.
The wall.
Using Frostbite.
It's our armor. It protects us from what lies beyond.
What the?
But out there, you either live with the choices you make, or die trying to change them.
Is this a Titanfall game?
The story doesn't end here. It's just the beginning.
Okay.
Oh.
All right. I'm into that a lot. Now basketball for the next
hour. Hey, everybody.
Hour.
I'm Sean
Man,
O'Brien,
that game looks so cool.
And I'm here
cool.
Today to share the latest about NBA Live 18 with you.
They're bringing back Live.
But
okay.
Instead of talking about it.
Yeah, that's what I said before
like
the show. There's been rumors they're going
to
bring it back.
We spent the last 2 years completely overhauling virtually every aspect of gameplay. Now we're going to go outside to a hand.
You know, I'm glad they're
going to
bring back Live.
Fest.
Give some competition
some
in the NBA
and then
scene. Madden
we're
needs
come
it.
Come back in here. It'll give you more details.
They tried
how
bringing
NBA
back
Live 18 introduces an entirely
a few times.
New way
yeah,
to
three.
Play a basketball
yeah, 3 years ago
it
was
we
a
call
ball,
it the one.
A big
they,
time
they
bust.
Can't give
Gibbs,
Madden
Connor,
competition because EA owns the rights.
Thank
to
you, Sean. You look
well, right for
every
now.
Every single time
I know they're coming up soon.
So how interesting is it that we'll cover this in the post show real quick?
I am telling you right now, I am excited to see a first look at NBA
single
Live
person
18,
I see
and
BioWare
no one better in the business
wallet.
Than my guy right here, creative director, Connor Dugan. Connor, let's take first
Connor.
Look at NBA Live 18.
Yeah, what's up? I mean, we're excited that
they didn't allow us in the building, so we just set up shop
NBA
here.
Live. The replay we just got.
Is it just me, or am I still thinking about this BioWare IP and have no, like, fucking shits about this game? I don't care about NBA right now.
I'm using my right stick dribble control. I'm performing any combination of moves I want.
What's up, Plague Dig?
And now I'm trying to catch the
basket.
But KD cuts me
off. Look at basketball players move.
And then I try to go back at him again. This time I'm going to go middle. But Hugh's late. He doesn't hit his left stick. He misses a timing window. And now I have an open lane to the hoop. So we see Zaza coming over.
Tell me he finishes strong. He finishes strong.
I use my right stick to finish with the left hand. As you can see here, right over top of Zaza, finishing the lane. And then there we have it. LeBron's looking like LeBron. Nice tight shot.
Classic LeBron, baby.
No, I'll believe good gameplay when I see it.
They're touting the tight shot there.
Back to you.
Whoa, it looks like NBA 2K15. That's the burn of the day. That is the burn of the day.
I'm excited for all of you to get your hands on NBA Live 18. And everyone will have an opportunity.
Yeah, 2K is still going to be the game.
So FIFA gets an hour, basically. NBA Live gets 5 seconds.
This demo will give everyone the chance to start the one and be introduced to this new basketball world. Jumpstart your own legacy through solo, co-op, and multiplayer experiences and carry all of your progress over to the full game. Now let's take a look at the one.
I mean, it doesn't
NBA
look
Live
terrible.
NBA Live 18 is an all-new way.
It looks weird. Like the last Live game, though.
Centered on you.
Yeah. Well,
your journey
all
is defined by the choices you make. Welcome to the One. The One unleashes the freedom to play
NBA
how
2K is
and
a
with
franchise
whom you
that's
want.
So big
here,
right now.
The respect you earn on the streets matters just as much as the rings you earn in the league. Rise through the ranks in the league. An authentic NBA experience.
Okay, so just give us
where
an NBA
you dominate
streak,
the hardwood on your way to winning championships. But the new NBA
His
Live
last name
goes
is
beyond the,
one. The
league, taking you into the streets, where the rules and how you earn respect are different. Team up with friends to take down NBA legends at historic courts like Venice Beach. Throughout your journey, your on-court performance leads to increased skills and new gear as your hype builds in both the streets and the league.
NBA
From Venice to Rucker Park and
oh,
everywhere
okay,
in between.
In.
Join the community with 5-on-5 pickup games at iconic, real-world courts. Hit the Drew League and continue to build your legacy in the Pro-Am Tour.
But
earn the right to go head-to-head with the,
the
very
Drew
best
League?
It's run by
and show
Drew.
Off your signature Man. Style.
Is that supposed to be like Uncle
from
Drew
East Coast
from
to
like,
West Coast?
I think
from the
right.
Streets
the Kyrie
to the
Irving thing?
Everything you do matters. Your legacy is defined by you.
But I mean, does this even interest you guys? Even if you did play basketball
world.
Games, does this
it's time
make
for
you,
you
even
I
think about
2K games? And I like the street stuff there better than the actual.
No offense, but nothing about basketball interests me. If it were NBA Jam or NBA Street, then
that's what I was gonna say. Just give me NBA Street.
Yeah.
Bring back the Street franchise.
Or give me an official NBA Jam. I mean, EA did that several years ago, and it was actually a lot of fun.
None of this is hockey or baseball. None of this is hockey or baseball. Somebody do something. This isn't hockey or baseball.
Give me a white man can't jump game.
Yeah, I want to play as Woody Harrelson. I'm really surprised it's getting this much time.
Or an HD Space Jam.
This has to be their last chance to revive the series. If this game is dog meat, then they're done. They cannot bring it back this many times.
Yeah.
How many times does this series get a reboot?
Live hasn't been out since, what, 15? NBA Live 15?
No, yeah,
the last
was
one?
14.
It was a 16.
Thanks, guys.
It was a 16.
And thanks to all of the teams here sharing.
It's been about two or
today.
3 years.
And a special thanks to Joseph
if
and
they don't
Hazel.
Get this right, yeah, I don't know.
How about
that
for some
again.
Passion? Now, we got a massive finale coming up here in just a moment.
Uh-oh.
30 minutes of pure, unadulterated Star Wars.
Shit.
But before we get there, I wanted to pause for just a moment. Last week, we did something pretty amazing together.
I kind of forgot.
We held our annual EA Play to Give campaign, celebrating the importance of inclusion and play in our communities and in life.
So, I don't want to dog too much before we see Star Wars, but
an anti-bullying organization,
we got a little bit of Madden at the very beginning, but they gave NBA Live more time than they gave Madden.
We donated $1 million to these three great organizations in support of building
Ben Kenobi says Star Wars sucks.
Star Wars sucks.
It's the most ironic statement of the day.
You do, but when they're talking about, maybe they'll show more tomorrow at Microsoft, and that's why. Because they're talking about, they were talking about Scorpio and like how it looks so powerful and all that. It looks so nice and everything. But then they really don't show much with Madden other than that very initial trailer that kicked off the press conference. Or the showcase, excuse me.
Starting today for the rest of the week, Origin Access, as well as the Vault and EA Access, are free. Wow. For PlayStation 4 players, we'll also have a bunch of free trials running all week. We're talking FIFA, Madden,
so EA Access is free to everyone
Garden
right
Warfare
now.
2, Star Wars Battlefront, and much more. So jump in, bring your friends, have fun with some great games this week while you're getting ready and excited for what's to come. Now, without further ado, we bring you Star Wars Battlefront 2.
Everybody shut the hell up.
All right, here we go. Oh, I mean, a whole other page of notes.
Coming right out and saying, okay, this is how we screwed up. So, let's fix it.
Yeah, even coming from John Boyega himself, and just at least they're being humble enough to say, hey, we effed up.
This is dumb. It's not gameplay at all.
Hey, it's okay, I'm into this so far.
Lady in a skirt, isn't she nice?
Hello.
Who's this?
Princess Upskirt.
Oh, it's
I'm Janina Gavon Carr. And I play Commander Iden Versio.
You played
Shiva
Kamini Koma Kondakram on the lead.
In Star Wars Battlefront.
If you guys know what that show is.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, there we go. All right. All right. That's cool.
Shiva Kamini.
I'm also an advocate for in-depth cinema caliber story in games.
Why does she look so angry?
I don't know.
That tweet from John
Boyega.
She's
very angry looking to be presenting Star Wars.
Was like the tweet heard around the world. It spoke for all of us.
Oh, maybe she's mad at John Boyega.
When can we play a Star Wars story?
Fuck you, John Boyega.
Watch them a million times.
She gets sassy.
Yeah,
fuck you, John
episode
Boyega.
One.
Is have a new
God.
And authentic.
Okay, so yeah, so she plays the lead role for
a story
this
that
game.
Delivers
cool.
New perspectives and enables us to play as some of our favorite Star Wars characters while also introducing new ones. And just like
Never
Rogue
Break
One
character,
tells
exactly.
An essential
yep.
Star Wars
I gotta say, that
story
is a really
ahead
cool
of a new
dress.
Hope. Star Wars Battlefront 2 will tell a new Star Wars
I like
Wars
the
story
addition
that
with
helps
the red
the
and the black and showing that in game as well.
Jedi
right.
And the Force Awakens.
She's high enough.
That's the motto for EA's show is,
it's
are you
good.
High enough?
What's
but
up?
EA
how you doing, A-Rob?
Stop there. We loved the previous Battlefront of 2015, but we wanted more.
Don't say loved.
Star Wars Battlefront 2 is much bigger than the previous title, with more than three times the content of the first game. Yeah.
Yay, three.
Now, I'm all about that couch co-op, and they're
no
bringing
one,
it
no
back
one loved that
with the return
game.
Of Skirmish, so I'm going to be cuddling up with someone playing me some Battlefront 2.
What?
In multiplayer, there
what?
Are heroes, more vehicles,
there we go.
More
say,
planets.
That's the live stream he wants to see.
More space battles and starfighter assault, and deeper progression and customization, as well as content from across all
There you go,
eras.
Jeff. Loot boxes.
But...
I'm kidding.
As we know,
that's all I need.
Star Wars is not just some checklist of great features. How does Battlefront 2 play? The team at DICE in Stockholm has some of the most talented multiplayer designers in the world.
Yes.
And
they've development
been working to game changers
that
to make sure Star Wars Battlefront 2
that guy is
has
high as hell,
the
so
multiplayer.
High. Is my mouth hanging open?
These game changers, they basically get like... tapped on the shoulder because they're the best Battlefront players in the world, and then they get secretly flown out to Stockholm. As long as they provide valuable
Battlefront
feedback,
isn't
they
that
get an
like
early
part of a
game.
Game.
Sounds like an awesome program, and if I didn't suck at multiplayer, maybe I'd get an invite. That's true. So, let's hear more from them about their time
We need two petitions
DICE.
For her. I'll cover those in a minute.
This is still not gameplay footage. What is going on?
Okay,
after
so
the release of Star Wars Battlefront
1,
the community thought there should have been more. And the good news is this, the developers have been listening.
So I want to petition that she hosts
I'm really
Ubisoft's
excited to let the game changers get their hands
on
again.
This
is
going to
stay.
The dress that she's wearing
is
one of the
UI
items you get
in
the loot
box. There's still time to change something if it's not working. Oh my god! My first impression with the game is upgraded. All three eras are going to be in the game.
No! First boss coming at me!
Oh, okay, Palos Plus! We've got a whole bunch of new features. One of the biggest ones that a lot of fans are excited about is the class system. They split the characters up into different classes.
They have different weapons, special abilities that you can customize.
It affects your health. It affects how you are going to support your team.
There's going to be more content. You're going to have to get used to a lot of new different techniques and how to play.
The gunplay and the weapons have completely been
so we're getting gameplay through this video.
Now there is a lengthened skill gap in
I'm
it.
Sure we'll get gameplay, but
a lot
just give us the
dark.
Gameplay, damn it.
This gun feels kind of more real, less floaty.
Which is your favorite hero so far?
We're introducing a system called battle points, which
I
will
can
allow
tell
you to
this,
become
starting
not only
in a sound
heroes, but other things on the
so
battlefield.
Good.
As you're helping
amazing.
Your team play the objective, you gain these points.
There's such a plethora of things to spend it on, vehicles,
or even coming in as a hero.
And the coolest thing, I think, is the level of customization, not just from a weapon standpoint, but the actual
screen.
Character's own abilities.
Oh, yeah. That's who I want to play as. I don't give a fuck if it's whiny or not.
Collaborating with the Game Changers is always a really great working environment when you're trying to figure things out.
I mean, to know that you're giving key feedback to make it a better experience for everybody, it's like putting your footprint out there and saying, look, I'm part of this.
Is everyone in position?
Yeah.
Ready?
Fix the space battle controls.
So I'm going to participate in making the trailer. It's a whole different level of fantasy.
All right, recording.
So in 3, 2, 1.
And now, on behalf of the EA Game Changers and DICE, this is the world premiere of Star Wars Battlefront 2 multiplayer gameplay.
All right, here we go.
Nipples are hard. I love you, Frostbite Engine.
Yeah. That's been the one theme I've seen through this entire showcase.
Criteria.
Everything
okay.
Looks fantastic.
Ooh.
Looks so nice.
Okay, I'm in.
Ooh.
I'm in. I want.
So they're starting with original Kuro, which is never a good idea.
That's all right. You gotta work your way up.
By original, I mean episode 1, 2, 3.
Yeah.
Right. The first three.
Yeah. First three. You gotta start them all. I'm in. Give me this game now. Give me all of this.
I kept saying Darth Maul, damn it.
EA puts on good trailers.
Oh,
yeah.
Yeah,
they do.
Damn it!
Is this gameplay footage?
Boba Fett! Oh! Yes!
Oh, wow.
Yes!
Oh, yeah.
All wings! We're coming up on the Star Destroyer, but
oh,
we need to clear
shit.
That escort.
Come on. Come on.
I imagine this is in-engine.
It's gotta be in-engine. I don't know if it's actual gameplay.
No,
we'll see
not.
Gameplay in just a second here.
Okay.
There she- there's the...
Unusual.
As the Emperor in Destiny gear.
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay, that's a good trailer.
All right, good trailer.
Got a marketing deal with Sony, which we knew that already.
Yeah.
Yoda,
dude,
Darth Maul.
EA is blowing
Kylo
it out of the water
Ren
with the,
Rey.
The gameplay,
I
like,
that thing like 20
or
times,
just the trailers so in general. The look.
This even started. My mom's here. Yes, it's a big day for me. I'm sorry. So.
Okay, I like her.
Can we get her to host every EA conference from now on?
Yes.
All right.
Okay.
That's a petition.
So we have even more exciting things for you. In just a moment, YouTube personality I, Justine, shoutcaster Alex Goldenboy Mendez, and DICE developer Paul Kesslin will showcase Assault on Theed, the world premiere of Star Wars Battlefront 2's multiplayer. Yep. We've
okay,
got
so this is gonna be actual
game
changers
ready
I'm
to
cool
go.
With that.
Head to head in a 20 versus 20
adventure,
match.
Excitement, a Jedi
Babylon
craves
Theed
not these
and
things.
On the dark side. 40th slot. We'll see.
Sith Forlorn.
Okay, but you're not going to want to miss this. Not like, maybe you've frosted seen some shredded teasers, wheat. This is the
just
real
shredded
thing,
wheat.
Okay?
Thanks, thanks
whistles,
Doc Croc, for checking out.
Newness,
see you, Doc Croc.
And Poseidon.
There, another big Star Wars Battlefront fan has some exciting news.
Hi, guys. It's John Boyega here. Thought I wasn't going to turn up. Yes, I was.
Oh,
I'm sorry
okay.
I can't be there with you because I'm doing a play in London. But I do have some great news. Obviously, you know I'm a massive fan of Star Wars Battlefront 1. And now we're going into the next chapter with Star Wars Battlefront 2. And I'm very, very excited to share this news with you. We've seen Yoda. We've seen Luke. We've seen all the other characters. But where's Finn? Finn will definitely be a part of Star Wars Battlefront 2 alongside with Captain Phasma as part of the first season of free content. And there's more. On top of that, we also get
free
to play on
content.
The new planet Crait that you saw on the Last Jedi teaser trailer in April. So this is going to be an exciting time. I'm going to be playing. You see Finn running around whooping some ass. It's me. So I'm getting ready, getting set for you guys to play with me on Star Wars Battlefront 2. And I'm excited. Let's play.
Okay, but did you listen? Finn and Phasma are headed to Star Wars Battlefront 2 this holiday, and it will be free. Yes. The team at DICE heard our feedback loud and clear on the previous Battlefront and are committed to keeping this community together with themed seasons of content post-launch for all players at no additional charge.
EA's been doing that with Titanfall, especially with free content.
Yeah.
Great idea.
The first season,
you're seeing that with a lot more
by Star Wars,
in games
the
in general.
The Last Jedi is only the beginning of the additional content coming to this game. All post-launch heroes, maps, weapons, and vehicles will be free everyone who owns Star Wars Battlefront 2. Yes.
So all DLC, all free.
And yesterday, EA announced that players who pre-order will get early access to multiplayer beta and Yoda's epic lightsaber mastery star card.
Of course.
So, let us recap.
Beta said fall.
New essential Star Wars story. Multiplayer across all three Star Wars
eras. Yes, so no
eras,
season pass.
Space battles, split-screen co-op, and free content that will keep us playing together for years to come.
There must be some paid DLC.
There's gotta be.
Yes,
cosmetic
right?
Stuff.
Yes.
Well,
yes.
Or is it just, just cosmetic like...
I am so honored to be just a
microtransaction
kind of
stuff.
This
yeah.
team making this amazing game.
How much extra will you pay to have her dress in the game?
They let me do this today. Mm-hmm. And I can't wait to play the game in its entirety in November. And I get to start right now. So I'm going to go pick up my controller and I'm going to throw it over to iJustine and Golden Boy and Paul to take us to Assault on Theed, the world premiere of Star Wars Battlefront 2's multiplayer.
All right.
Thanks so much. Hey guys, welcome to the world premiere of Star Wars Battlefront 2's multiplayer gameplay, Assault on Theed. We're ready to show you guys the live gameplay for the first time. I'm your host, iJustine, and with me here today,
I always want my character to look cooler, look better.
If Street Fighter 4 cost or Street Fighter 5 costumes weren't like $4
first of all, what we're
going to
see today is a three-stage mode. It's our new gameplay. We'll be showing people going. The droids are attacking Theed. They'll be going all the way up the main pathway towards the Royal Palace. They need to escort the MTT
screen
tank.
Right here.
From there, if we progress to stage 2, the droids need to try to bypass security, make their way into the palace itself. If they're successful, they'll be able to take on the throne room. And there, the droids will ideally try to capture that from the clone army. Unfortunately, the clone army's still there, needs to try to push them out and make that last stand.
Can we just take a moment here and appreciate the fact that we get to be droids in Star Wars? This is going to be awesome. I can't wait. Are you guys excited?
Overhead view. RTS confirmed.
You guys got to come alive. We're here
new Empire at War.
Great gameplay. We have some great game changers who are going to be competing here. And I use competing as a term because these guys are holding nothing back just yet.
Yeah, no, it's been super exciting. And we got a chance to play yesterday. And it's just really fun to
they
sort of get into
this
environment.
You know,
it's something that we've
I
seen in
not.
The movies. But we're actually
I
in the
don't
gameplay.
Know.
And
so this, is,
who has
and so the, this footage
the
says
so
pre-alpha
about
build.
What we're seeing here and getting into this, because there's three phases to this. So currently, we're in phase one.
That's right. And also, we
not today.
You saw one of
not today,
just
Rob.
While it was VF updates, Pool Shark. Moose Elk. We also have my boy Darkness, a.k.a. Dankness.
Also NBA
he
Live.
Be playing as well. We have Westy, Master G.
This is going great, by the way.
HQ.
What and was that?
We're just going to go to NBA Live?
You know? Yep.
What's going on?
But anyway, here
Remember
you go.
Us?
So, Star Wars Battlefront
We're still outside.
Two,
you get that one
now,
rebel who's
awesome
like, fuck Star Wars, I'm playing NBA Live.
Yeah.
Down the street of feed here. And
getting 30 minutes of Star Wars.
No, 29 minutes and like a 30 seconds of NBA Live.
even if this is a so-called pre-alpha build, this looks really good.
Yeah.
Like, looks really cool.
Phase two, but right now we're seeing some specialist gameplay from, I think, Battlefront updates.
Yeah, let's actually talk about the specialists. And also, you're going to see a couple different classes here. This class in particular that Massive G is using is the heavy class. Specialist, Connie or Sniper, right? But the
exactly.
Heavy class, what do they do here?
So the Heavy class is great. They got a bit more health than your average Trooper. They're also able to pop that combat shield, try to push into areas. So
here
you can see
go.
Those guys as pushers and defenders in some areas.
That looks
but
very
look at
cool.
One of our Vulture droids right now. Not sure who's flying this guy, but these guys are great at air-to-air, trying to take out those other ships that might be coming
Not sure
in
who's flying this guy, but he's fucking shit
Otherwise,
up.
They're great ground support like we're seeing here.
He's definitely
to get some runs in on those cones.
Oh! Yeah.
Oh!
Come on, man.
Missed that time.
No!
That
cool.
You just did it wrong there, buddy.
See?
Sorry.
We also do have the air support, but we also have ground support.
You just did it wrong there, buddy.
Also, another thing that air vehicles are great at is trying to take out some of the ground vehicles that you may see. The droid army has the AAT tank, something that's really great at troop suppression. But we see here a little clip of the V-Wing doing
okay,
that.
Here
oh,
we go.
Man, he's just mowing some droids down there.
Yeah, just absolutely shredding. You're going to see this happen
V-Wing
quite a bit, especially
cool.
In this phase, because there's a lot of open field here, right? And you
it's
can just come
PC
through
game for, me
for great
sure.
Straight, great bombing runs, really.
I mean, look
and
at the sky. Look at those clouds.
And also, you put the presence of an air
just,
vehicle.
Dave was talking about the lighting
look
game.
Look
that looks fantastic.
First person shooters.
Do
the clouds look like animals?
Can
I
find a
first person shooter?
Absolutely. And you can see right now that there is an AAT tank sitting around.
No, the clouds look awesome, Justin.
He is probably taking out those clone troopers, but this droid, this vulture droid, is really.
Justice Scooby,
what
this
I love
does
about
look
this
great.
Is everyone's like, oh, look at this great open map. And then when you start phase two, it's like everything starts coming in and coming way closer together. And we were talking
like
a little bit more
the
about the assault class.
That's
so for somebody who just started playing this, never played any previous
See, they're, what EA is doing is they're just playing to my weakness by showing something that looks really
yes,
cool
yes,
and making it look
that's
fun.
Ooh.
And also showing
that
it's a video game. Those are all
of
my weaknesses.
Be able to jump right into. They're your frontline flanker attacker. I think they're going to be
You're like good looking, fun video game.
And just start having
No way.
Run and gun action. Their signature ability, you see here at the top of the screen, your number two ability, that switches you over to a shotgun. You get a little bit faster, and you're able to really get in there and kind of, you know, break through those front lines.
Oh, I love it. I love using the shotgun, man. It is so good. And it's actually, when I first used it, it really caught me off guard. I wasn't expecting it. And I said, wait a minute. Destroy people with it. So I just charged into the room.
That does
and
not look like it should be flying.
Everyone. It was so fun
with that wings,
to play with.
Wing
we also
structure.
Seen some great dogfighting here between the clones
I'm
and
sick.
The Separatists. This is certainly
Dude,
what a lot of folks
give
love
me Crimson Skies.
Okay, what I will say is very interesting is no talk of any VR modes or anything like that. Right.
No, no. Oh, wow. Upside down. Man, this is wicked. Yeah, no VR.
He's playing Assault Class again. You saw him. He had the signature thermal gun here.
But I'm okay with it. I mean, it is what it is.
Some of those guys with as he rushes in.
They'll show that more at
Sony. Like one of the guns that used was the semi
with
the
PSVR
gun.
And
yep. You know, fire
all their setup.
Slower, but you can get some great shots with it. And then there's also this nice compact.
So you get a big ass tank
style, you know,
yep.
Blaster that really shreds through people in close range. I was, you know, using a little.
I mean, we
want
to give you a little bit more weapon
too.
Variety this time around, you know.
Yeah.
Also, some AAT tank action here, and this is that doing what it does best. It's suppressing that point, trying to keep those clones out of the way.
They're trying to make their way forward as the. Objective continues to march down. He has to get away from that.
He's trying to, I don't know, is he trying to flank the tank? That's not smart.
I don't know, man. Maybe he will. Maybe
you saw a little combat roll there. Got to give you some escape options in case you get into some hairy action.
Uh-oh, we didn't get to see this one before. Finally.
Oh, we haven't.
Some
ATRTs. Oh, okay.
Yes. So these are great for kicking out those ATRTs. So these guys are a little
I like this.
They have an
I like this
charge
whole...
ability. That way they'll be able to do a little bit more extra damage against the tank should they see it.
That's
so
cool.
You can imagine like three or four of these on the battlefield really rushing
what
around
if
points. Look at this.
Konami came out and said, hey, here's Metal Gear Solid 1 through 4, redone in boxing.
You can run someone over if you want.
Would that be a sell for you guys?
Could I get shot off of it if I'm on top of it because my body's
Yeah.
That question was answered, you know, instantly.
Almost immediately.
Yeah, almost immediately. Oh, man. So, Mr. Muselk here, you know, look for this guy to be on a tear a little bit later as well. And also, I did want to highlight, we had an officer, as a matter of fact, right in front of Star Wars
HQ. We did,
HQ
one of my
there.
Favorite classes.
What is it about the officer that makes it so unique?
I mean, my Twitch skills aren't where they used to be. I'm Fair. A bit slower nowadays, but I'm able to really buff up my
other than,
class,
like, updated graphically,
try to
I feel like this is what Battlefront 1 should have been.
Yes.
Oh. Ooh. What happened there?
Finally some good dogfighting going in there.
Okay.
So
all right. And one starfighter.
What's great about some of these starfighters is these are accessed through our new battle point system. So instead of finding a pickup token on the map like we used to in the last game, you're now able to, depending on how well you do, whether you're scoring points via kills, via team play assist,
I feel like
the objectives like you really want players to do, you're earning points continuously that will allow you to spend
a lot of positive around it now that could help a community be sustained with all the free DLC, all the extra stuff, the stuff they're doing right this time.
Yeah,
it's
definitely going a long way to try and bring gamers back in.
Right.
I wonder if they were just trying to, but once we get inside, the first Battlefront game just testing the waters and see if people still cared about it.
What is this happening right?
Could have been
with this. Okay. Those older games were actually really good, here, so it'd be more like those.
Well, and that's what, if you look at the chat, Justice Scooby says, yeah, this is much closer to the old Battlefront for the PS2, nice Xbox, and what people wanted to begin with.
Yes. Team,
I mean, he's
right?
Kind of,
he's
accurate. I mean,
it's trying to cover you from the air.
More,
oh boy. So, and
more of what we should have gotten in.
As well. You get those,
how many points you're earning?
Right.
That's
so
right.
You can use those later on. Got some specialist gameplay
single
here as
player
well. Maybe
versus AI as an option.
Perhaps.
Just a regular multiplayer match, but if people aren't playing it enough,
yeah,
I want
so
by myself
so if
AI bots playing.
You
know, I've always played this game.
Star Wars Cross Time Splitters.
Especially potent in this area because it's is such a big open area.
But I mean,
the
original
really
Battlefront 2 had
well.
That. So you can do it right now if you want to.
And just absolutely tearing them up. I have to say, man, Musou is killing
to.
It. Killing it in this world.
Again.
Well, I was just going to say, do you go back and does this make you want
to
play
right next to one of the clones?
This last iteration or go back even
pushing,
further?
Right? You want to be able to push
play the old?
Definitely.
Support your team like...
Because like EA Access is free right now if you're an Xbox user, and then obviously PS4 is getting some free game stuff as well. So
you
can play. Well, right. I
like
for me, I'm not. I've been debating on doing it,
and
it's free, so I could jump in and play Star Wars right now.
Scooby, I agree. Star Wars is definitely my weak spot.
Yeah.
And you know, give a little bit more fire support for that area.
Well, not just like the first one. We all agreed the first one was more on the lackluster side.
Go into combat
and,
with Musou, who's up there. There's a darkness
still bought it.
Just shredding everyone up here. Maybe he can get
I played a shit ton of the Star Wars first. This
this
new iteration of Star Wars Battlefront, the first one.
Mode,
but like Jeff said, it died down
up
really fast.
Some huge area effect shots. You lock down your position, but you're able to have a lot more firepower.
Oh damn!
We also just saw the B2
yeah, fucked up.
Super Battle Droid there as well. That's something you can get.
Another one of my favorites.
Well.
Another one of my favorites. Yeah, you can grab those guys via the battle point system. Those guys.
Do you think EA
pushes
this as an esports site?
High health, a lot of rapid fire.
It sure feels like it.
It does, doesn't it?
There it is.
And this big explosion indicates phase
that is
one
cool.
is over. Now
so what mode is this then that they're
two.
Doing these phases?
This is
and is this against...
Really
is
this
is
like the operations mode that
really
Battlefield
tight
1
inside
has?
Of that building, and
okay.
players
I
need
think.
To be mindful of that. And look for this B2 to just shred
really
through everyone, especially with
on
that
PC,
cooling
so
ability that he has.
If there's still an active community for
it
on PC,
constantly shooting in the fight.
He's gonna make a huge difference here as the fight moves.
PC Master Race!
He's gonna be able to just shred as soon as anybody gets
let me get a drink of my alcohol.
Those narrow corridors could be trouble.
And just waiting for the prime opportunity to push up
Battlefield
here.
And those kind of games have always been PC games.
Here we go.
This is where it starts
okay,
to get
so
interesting.
I'm buying
the real one. Darth Maul will excel in face.
Heavy breathing intensifies.
He's a great mobile attacker.
Darth Maul is the coolest character in Star Wars, period.
He is a badass character.
Absolutely.
He is the coolest character.
Some of his abilities you can see here, he's got that spin attack. He's able to just rush in and out of combat and just take guys out in the process.
It was funny, I was
looks very fluid. Lots of huge
and
jump.
Using Darth Maul, and he was saying how there's Boba Fett as well.
Here's the second coolest character in Star Wars history, Boba Fett.
Darth Maul could reflect. I was like, if he could reflect, he'd be too strong. He'd be way too strong.
Oh,
there's
Boba
Fett.
That was a good flank by Boba Fett and Maul. Just shredded the
Boba Fett just coming in and fucking shit up. He said,
This game, nice lighting here.
Yeah, I was just thinking in a pre-alpha build.
This looks amazing.
Yeah.
With that jetpack of his, he's able to kind of float above the
battlefield. I feel like this is pre-alpha build.
Really take out an individual target.
It either feels a little bit further along or than what they're saying, or this game is going to look incredible.
Rocket barrage instead of just one rocket, he's able to reach
in the final build.
Nice. Also, one thing to keep in mind, we saw the B2, here we go, but on the clone side, you know, there are specialist characters that you can pick up as
what
well.
What was
we haven't seen much of it yet, but that would be the clone
villain's name in Force Awakens.
His name is escaping me.
Kylo Ren?
Yeah.
From Battlefront,
you know,
the original.
That's right.
I like his look.
Here, but now focus on the central
the helmet,
the
mask. Everything.
Back to Boba Fett here.
Yes, but yeah. And he's I get it. He's whiny. He reminds me of Damien from Injustice 2. But yeah, Kylo Ren is the character that, with the mask on, with the helmet on, I'm actually kind of interested to play as well.
Yeah.
Maybe not as much as Darth Maul, but
the
look is
cool. Team, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Now, what is his 2 exactly?
Sorry, my mind's not working
100%. Yeah, exactly. It's a healing ability. It gives you a little bit of...
Engrossed in this gameplay.
Over health, but it also heals you back
for
up.
For pre-alpha build, this blows...
Jump troopers.
I feel like this blows Battlefield 1 out of the water, just in pre-alpha.
For phase 3 in just a little bit.
Is it just me, or does anybody else feel that way?
Jump troopers
are
super fun to play, but again, you know, it's attached
so Jeff,
to a specialist
you,
now.
Or, and Dave,
so
you guys picked this up. You guys picked
really
this up day one. What do you go?
But I'm going to be excited.
Do you think it's Is it a PS4 pickup? PC pickup?
Oh, now we've got Rey.
PC.
Not gonna lie.
My PC,
PC
would melt if it tried to run this game. So.
Yeah, I'm saying I go
really
don't
run quickly, but they got her.
Probably
a
PS4 for me. I've got a pretty beefy PC, so this
absolutely. So Rey's mind trick is something that against all enemies, they'll be confused
for a
little bit.
Console.
Your controls will kind of work against
1060
you, making you a little bit more vulnerable to attack.
My PC and it puts it down.
This is when it gets insane.
It's a good mid-price card.
So much going on here. And was that a little Han?
We saw a little Han.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Are we going to get some Han?
We see Han Solo?
But I mean, you saw it earlier. So every time you finish a life, we'll show you how many battle points you have. And some people have enough points to get those reinforcements. And especially this late in the game, you'll see a lot more of these special classes coming out. A lot more of the heroes.
I'm interested to see how
again,
this looks on Scorpio.
Here, you know, with his rocket launcher,
I mean, with
his jump back.
I've always been an Xbox
gamer,
to
that last
so
dome and capture a point.
This is really where heavies are.
I hope this.
As well because
there
they,
is.
And, my goodness,
I'm
see
not gonna happen, but I
the
hope
doorway,
there might be a cross
just
play.
Absolutely
option.
Dominating.
Yeah,
I
never understand why they don't
fight this one out
with
here.
Xbox.
There are so many lives left that
well,
the
I understand.
Have.
But then you get PC
team,
and PS4
really
playing with each other.
The have to start acting fast
you would think Microsoft could just
it,
let its own community
it.
Play with each other.
Will win this game.
It's not looking so good for my boys in the Clone Army.
I'm a Separatist fan. So I'm excited.
I'm just going to go on whichever team wins.
Oh,
I'm not even paying attention to who's winning this game.
Okay,
I don't even care.
I understand that. You know, no loyalties. Maybe you
that is cool. Just the jetpack, the thrusters, the lighting, the smoke.
Shots fired.
Yeah, so in this third phase, though, in the droids are trying to capture that throne room. So you can see here, if you remember, it's just this is the
main all three eras.
And this is
a
super close quarters. Do you have any like sort of strategies?
Yes.
Timelines.
If you're the clones, you're hoping that. Oh, geez.
Han Solo was just getting torn up.
This is gonna be trouble.
It's like too soon, man. I can't relive Force Awakens again. You know, like don't do it.
Darth Maul is just destroying absolutely everything.
Disney's not
but
fucking around. They're
to, like,
giving
you
all
down?
Star Wars.
I mean, you want to have a try to combined arms fire.
Oh.
The tip is. Blasters.
Run away. Maybe run away.
Run
don't
away
even care that you lost.
Crap
this is
not
okay.
Oh, man.
I know.
Oh man.
He was our MVP.
That's
look
their
that.
Cursor.
Nice stuff.
That's
awesome. Congratulations. 36 kills he ended up picking
my
up there,
goodness.
Man.
My goodness.
Okay,
well, guys,
the hype
that
is real.
Was it. What did you guys think?
Man, there was a lot of players.
I actually,
there's a
I'm,
lot
I'm
of players.
Sad.
He's
awesome.
Gonna play
I
Destiny
it.
2
so
on
good.
PS4.
Like, I love the class-based gameplay personally. Because again,
I have it on
you
both, but if
really
there's a content that will come over from previous
say, like,
game,
hey,
I'll play on
I want to, you know, run the officer, and we're, you know, we're running.
Well,
so
and obviously, if you're,
the best
they
know,
show
talking,
highlights
you know,
at the end.
Oh,
that's amazing.
I think this is not the game. I
think this is a crash montage. I think
is it them kind of showing highlights?
No.
All the time. I'm down with that.
But it was Musak. I mean, he's sitting there, you know, getting his
This is the actual game doing it. That's fantastic. This is Overwatch.
Oh, this is really cool.
Play the game deal. Points, keep earning them, keep earning
and I like it's more than just one play of the game. They're giving you multiple things that are happening. This is a pretty.
I think they, if they're going to do it, this is really cool, but they should have like a segment that is the play of the game.
Sure.
I don't know why. That's really motivating to me when I play Overwatch.
Well, yes, it is.
Unless you play the, you know, Junkrat, Drunk Jaws everywhere. Yeah.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
His Tyler Kill always gets it, or a Bastion always gets it.
I mean, you can see it looks so pretty. Just look at this laser.
Yeah, I mean, if there's one thing that's broken on in Overwatch, it is the play of the game. But it is still motivating. I want to get it.
Gushing right now. You know, like, we get it. The game looks good.
But I'm cool. They should have a play of the game to show you other highlights. That would be really cool.
I have to say, like, I can't wait to get my hands on it. I can't wait to coordinate with my friends, you know? And destroy the clone scum. I can't
wait
for
that.
Yeah, you know, exactly. Separatists all day.
Well, guys, that was so awesome. Now, if you guys are in
so
LA,
awesome.
You can come join us at FanFest this
so
weekend.
So awesome.
And if you come down on Monday, we've got a chance.
All right,
for you guys
I think that's about it for Battlefront.
Germany.
I don't think
this
there's
August.
Anything more on
all you have to do
we'll
is come and play, which is, I mean, that's not asking too much. And you have to be the best player of your match, and you guys will be entered to win a trip for two to Cologne, Germany, and a full pass to Gamescom.
Awesome.
You've been there.
Yeah, I've been there plenty of times. It's one of the most ridiculous conventions ever, if you happen to go. It's
where have I seen this
massive,
announcer
so
on the
not,
right front?
You're, if you don't get the trip, you're
your dreams.
If you do get the trip,
maybe.
Buddy.
I feel like he's a Halo announcer.
Hopefully I'll see you there.
Well, if you guys like Star Wars, like
it
we
doesn't
do, you guys
look like we're getting a new Star Wars game
Netflix
announcement today, Justice Scooby.
Star
I think our hype moment
right
was
now on Android or iOS.
I think
and
our hype moment was the new BioWare IP tease.
Yeah.
And many more. Paul, I also heard that you're making Battlefront 2 because you've been playing a lot of Galaxy of Heroes.
I play a ton of Galaxy of Heroes. I've played that game every day since it launched. I think I've actually spent about $1,000 in that game.
You have a problem.
I do have a problem.
Yeah,
oh,
but
man.
There's just so much Star
$1,000 on that game.
I gotta pick it up. I
why would you even admit that?
I know my brother. about it,
spending
so
money on mobile games has always been.
Yeah, I was actually playing in December, so around the holidays, that's pretty much all I did. It was great.
At Christmas, just in
all right.
Away,
sorry, I'm busy. Well, thank you guys so much for joining us here. Stay tuned to Battlefront2.com for more about the game, and we'll see you guys soon. Thanks, Paul, Golden Boy. This was incredible, and now I'm gonna send it over to Patrick for more.
For more, basically the wrap up here.
Thank you, everyone, and thank you to the real rock stars of this show, the development teams inside EA.
Rockstar
you are truly amazing.
That was a lot of Star Wars.
Now, we can't wait for more of you to play, and there's more coming. Stay tuned online for a closer look at some of our biggest game. And remember, EA Play is for all of you, our players. Thank you all for joining us. Now, let's play.
He could not have sounded less thrilled about that.
he didn't sound happy to be there at all.
How many Star Wars mobile games are there that this is the number one?
All of them.
All right.
There are way too many.
All right. That's it for EA Play. We did it. So, Star Wars Battlefront looks damn impressive, gang.
Let's see. Should we go from top of the show and kind of...
I got notes.
You got notes. All right. We can go from the top of the show if you want.
Sure.
All right.
So, they're just talking about Galaxy of Heroes and having
Madden.
There.
We got Madden. Yep. The Madden choir came out to drum up support for Madden.
Yep. So
a story mode. They're going the FIFA route with Madden.
Right. Yeah. I think just about all of their sports games are now going to have some form of single player story mode. So that's just going to be the standard EA thing going forward.
And I have FIFA 17. I need to check out that story mode a little more than I had before.
Well, and it looks, you know, they actually like so to say named this mode with Madden 18 Long Shot.
That's right.
So. I'm interested to see how they incorporate, and they chose, I put down a note, they chose the University of Texas to be where your player came from, so it's not like you have an option, it's just, this is where the person's coming from, kind of so to say.
Like, so if you hate Texas, you're screwed.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's intriguing. It's different. No Tom Brady, other than the fact that the drumline wore his jersey.
Yeah, that was... Well, he's the cover boy. I forgot about that. Right. He is the cover boy for this year. Madden's Madden. It's always going to be a decent football game, so yes. I'm not pumped for it.
It's a sports game.
Let's move on. Yeah. Battlefront 1 is getting some DLC. It's got the...
Battlefield 1.
Battlefield, I'm sorry. Battlefield 1.
It's tough.
Is getting a Russian-themed DLC mode in the name of the Tsar. I guess you're protecting Russian interests during World War One. You're playing as a legendary female fighting brigade. Looks really cool.
Yeah, it's more Battlefield 1, and it's a good game.
Eight
DLC I didn't buy yet.
I saw 8 maps.
Right. Yep. 8 maps. I wrote around 8 maps. Russian army. You get the Russian army. New vehicles. New weapons. The Knights DLC. So like basically all the maps you already get, you're getting again. But yeah, it looks fantastic.
It's more content for a good game.
Right.
Yeah, it made me want to play. So
it'll be interesting to see the dichotomy between that and then Battlefront. Did I get that right?
There you go.
It'll be interesting to see the dichotomy between that and Battlefront 2 when Battlefront 2 launches. So is one going to cannibalize the other? That'll be remaining to be seen.
I think they're different enough that people can get their Battlefield fix and also their Star Wars fix, and so people can play both.
Hopefully a community will build for Battlefront, so then you have both. You know, there's room for both. It's two different audiences. So I did also note down that they look to be having some sort of competitive Battlefield experience with smaller teams, kind of like I'm assuming a more competitive, as in like maybe like a 4 or 6 or 8 person team, not these 32, 64 men battles.
I'm hoping that means more, and I hate to use this analogy, but more of a Call of Duty, like more tight spaces and, you know, less reliance on vehicles and stuff like that.
Sure.
More kind of in your face stuff, which I enjoy that kind of those kind of games.
Right.
Also, no Titanfall anything.
No.
I think that one's done. Respawn's probably working on something brand new at this point.
Yeah, we got nothing from Respawn here, which is kind of a bummer.
Kind of a bummer and kind of surprising. I just seen I think it was an Instagram post from Respawn that said that...
Help, I'm locked in the closet.
They were there. They said they were there. So, I mean, who knows?
we're here. EA is revoking our passes, but we're here. We're trying to get in.
Yes, EA is the only show today.
Yeah.
Next show is tomorrow with Microsoft.
Yep.
Right.
All right. So here's my question. With the cool looking Battlefield 1 DLC, and then what we saw from Star Wars Battlefront 2, which one is it that you're wanting to play?
Battlefront. Star Wars.
Yeah. Same here.
I can play Battlefield 1 right now, and I think I will go home and do so. but when Battlefront comes out, that's going to be what I'm playing when I'm not playing Destiny 2.
Yep. When Battlefront comes out, that's the game I'm going to pick up. Like you said, I could pick up, or if you have it, you can play Battlefield now. So play that till the other one comes out, and then you're good to go.
Or don't, you know, it's your life, whatever.
Yeah, that's right, bro. Whatever you want to do.
All right, let's move on. Next up is the game that they're recapping right now on the stream, Need for Speed Payback. Now, I was a little bit more sour on this game because I missed the live action actors that were in the original Need for Speed.
Right.
But my God, this little gameplay glimpse looked really cool.
They're going into the dumb action, which is what I've always wanted from this series.
Right.
And they're leaning into it pretty hard, and I'm okay with that.
It looks like a Fast and Furious clone, but there's nothing wrong with that because there really isn't a Fast and Furious game that's out there that really does justice to that type of movie. But,
right. Well, and they're letting, in this case, what they're doing is they're letting Forza and the assumed coming Gran Turismo Sport fight the simulation, while this just lets you do something stupid and fun.
Right, yep. Right. So, it's just fast cars and a story and You know what they haven't really focused on is the open world aspect, which the reboot Need for Speed really focused on. So that's kind of interesting. I'll be intrigued to see where they go with that aspect as E3 goes on. They might be talking a little bit about that right now. Let me just bring some audio back up on that stream here.
Wrong one. Need for Speed Payback. So, we're going to be jumping into some stuff. Can you give me a little heads up of what we're going to check out?
Yeah, Need for Speed Payback takes all of the classic elements of Need for Speed that all of our fans love. It's got authentic car culture, iconic cars, deep customization, intense racing, epic cop chases, and gorgeous environments. We're taking all those classic environments, and we're putting them through the Hollywood lens. Turning Need for Speed Payback into the ultimate action-driving blockbuster.
So, should we just jump straight into
it? Let's do it.
All right. There you go.
Then, so we're going to jump into
random red headset.
What exactly action-driving blockbuster.
So this is one of our action-blockbuster missions in which we have three characters. We're introducing three characters in Need for Speed.
Oh,
one's Tyler, aspiring street racer. Second is Jess, who's going to be riding shotgun. Okay. She's the ultimate professional action hero.
Yeah, could be playing on a PC,
We've got Mac. He's going to be providing remote reconnaissance. He's a little bit of a joker, a little bit of a showman, providing a little comic relief, right? And so these three characters are going to work together to try to steal back a car that the house stole from them. Right, and the house is this evil cartel in the city of Silver Rock. They control all the street racing, they control the casinos, they control the cops. So really, they're stacking the dice against you.
Okay, so that's
like
what we see
Free
here with Koenigsegg being loaded up into the back of the trailer.
Did he just drop an against Chris Jericho drops an against?
Koenigsegg Regera.
He did. He did.
$2 million.
He totally Chris Jericho does.
That driver is not going to make it easy for you to try to
buy the game that much more.
These guys have devised a plan where they're going to hijack that truck and steal this car.
So I like this. I like this thought.
All right, sounds good. I think we can handle that. All right, so I will say I played this a couple of times.
These bad guys, so to say, control everything. You're kind of like this crew, and this group is trying to help take it down and steal back what's yours. That's kind of cool.
Fortune Valley. This is the
most diverse open world that we've ever built for Need for Speed.
No, it looks a little bit more like in-game. Yeah,
I think this is more in-game. Yeah. This guy is
drifting events and hill climbs. We've got the canyons and a desert. And this is a place called Ember Valley.
Looks so good.
You look at it, it's sunny, it's hot, it makes you thirsty just looking at it.
A good choice
for the perfect setting for an action-moving heist like the one you're about to do.
Right,
so one of the things that's already really cool is that I can just drive off-road. You're no longer confined completely to the roads.
That's right, it's the most open and even
like, so to say, the last one had.
So you can find your own path.
The last one looked fantastic, other than that.
And I love that when the UI is just part of the world.
You can explore this world.
Right.
It's integrated into the actual game space.
Cool.
The arrow.
So what's going on here? There's the truck. That's what we got to take
down. Point. You know, the crew, they're meeting here. They're waiting for this truck. It's carrying the $2 million Koenigsegg. It's going to whiz past here, and then Tyler and Jess are going to hop into action here. They're going to hop into their Mustang RTR.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, classic Need for Speed ride here. Right?
It's always
so what's the plan? What are we planning
to do? The classic.
Yeah, so Tyler's going to take the wheels, going to use his street racing skills to carve his
way
through.
I liked the crew. I was a big fan of the crew.
He's going to deal with some AI rivals.
I needed my beta.
Most importantly, he's going to drive and catch that truck so that Jess can get into position to hijack.
I'll never forget. I went into GameStop a couple of years ago. This looks so good. Went to GameStop a couple of years ago to pick up a copy of Drive Club. Club had just dropped $20, and they had added enough content that it was actually good.
Yeah, let's go.
And I was like, I was looking around. I was like, do you have a copy of Drive Club? I'm not seeing it. No, you should get the crew. I'm like, no, it is not the same type of game just because they have cars in it, dude.
We've got these cameras that present your biggest, baddest crashes in the game.
I mean, this game looks really nice.
But can this replace the crew? I think it's what it's trying to do.
You're not going to be able to see this hijacking motion, so you got to take.
I don't know if the crew is that high of a profile game right now. They need to be replaced.
Well, Need for Speed has the name recognition.
It does. The Crew 2 is coming out this year or next year, though.
Right. Yeah, Crew 2 is under development.
Look at this dust that's blown across the road. That is awesome.
That's cool. You'll probably see Crew 2 with Ubisoft on Monday?
So, yeah. Up to the truck and things never go to plan.
Yeah, in action movies, things go sideways.
So this is a cutscene.
So this is what we saw earlier.
Yeah.
It works with Microsoft and Bethesda?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
And one more.
We'll be talking about the software.
He has made an absolute mess of this highway.
I don't know, you know, just to kind of keep touching on what Justice Scooby was asking, I don't know if it's just going to, they have to worry about this beating the crew. I think this game sells better than the crew because it's Need for Speed, it's got the name recognition, and the crew didn't do so hot the first one, so this game still sells copies. You know, Need for Speed series still does really well.
So these guys have ramped up their attitude to 11.
These hit, the hits when these cars hit each other are so hard.
I was going to say, they really wish like Forza or Gran Turismo would take some note here, make those hits more impactful.
Good sense of speed, good sense of, you know, making that collision with other vehicles and stuff.
Yeah.
Good sense of badass.
There you go.
Oh, it's almost like they said, all right, we're taking the crash sequences and the physics from...
Oh!
You see?
Oh, that was
tough. Trying to get a 3 to go.
Come on, Nick.
So one of the things that's really cool is, the best way I kind of take it down is to crash into things in the environment, like using those poles.
It makes you want to go back and play the most recent Hot Pursuit.
Yeah.
That game was really good.
Yeah.
And so was the most recent Most Wanted.
Even if you replay it over and over again, you're
you just want to drive like a dick to the mall.
Trying to deal with them. They're tough, man.
Oh, really? The crew seems to have a decent-sized community still? You know, it was on for free on Xbox Live a while ago. I should pop it back in and play.
Yeah, I mean, I downloaded it for free, even with Games of Gold. Did you see that car just fly across the screen? That was so cool. But I never played.
These action movie moments, right? When you have these big crashes, we're going to present it to you.
That guy's drunk.
I'm gonna wait up for this guy so I can crash him out.
Yeah, he is high enough.
He's gonna come charge at you. Look out.
Hashtag, are you high enough?
Oh, wow.
You planned it, Nick. Yep, 100% on purpose, yeah. Of course.
All right, now punch it. You gotta catch it through the truck. Plan A went sideways, so we're gonna go.
So they took
the
it's almost like they took notes from the burnout crashes.
Yeah.
Big time. Like, it looks, the crashes, the physics, that looks really cool.
Here we go, you get into the city.
I should play the crew on PC.
Pushing hard.
Truck driver's gone to oncoming, making your life difficult. You gotta weave through that.
Look at E3, it's making us want to go back into our backlogs.
I know.
Right.
There we go.
Here's just a
screw playing games coming out. We'll do that later.
Yeah, games coming out?
No, we still have already out.
This is a cool sequence.
With three drivable characters, we have in our action missions of these dynamic vehicle switches. So you were playing as Tyler the Street Racer. Now you're going to jump into the Koenigsegg and you're drive as Jess.
Three drivers. You only play three player split screen.
And there you go.
Oof.
You got it. You've done this before.
That's cool. That's nice.
You've stolen a million dollar car before, right?
A couple of times.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, so now you got to
steal that sense
that
of speed.
So fast.
In this, awesome hypercar.
I would not be able to keep control.
Yeah, that's almost $2 million worth of a car right there.
Yeah.
So look out here. You've got epic golf cases. When you play the highway hike,
this is where they cut it off last time.
November 10th, you're going to have to use
right here after the show of the police.
Cops,
okay.
Avoid rhinos.
Still doing the same thing.
Roadblocks,
that's the E3
intense,
demo.
Car chase action that you expect from Need for Speed.
Cool. So what else can you tell me about the story really briefly?
Mm-hmm. So we
rest in peace, black car.
You're playing as these
it's always the black car, isn't it?
Lines, and it all comes together, them getting revenge against the house.
Cool. So should we jump into some customization and
do that.
See what we can do with some of these cars in this crazy, crazy world?
Sure. Yeah, so customization, right? Marcus has been talking about it in the live
right?
show. It's back.
Yes.
We're not going to do
loot boxes in every game.
Out of the ordinary? Yeah. Oh, maybe we will. I don't
know. Oh, maybe. Okay. Maybe.
Out of the ordinary.
Yeah. So yeah, this is Bryn, the vehicle director?
Vehicle art director.
Vehicle art director. There we go. So you know these cars inside and out.
Yes, I've lived and breathed them for the last couple of years.
All right, mm-hmm. So we're going to do some customization. Obviously, customization is huge for Need for Speed.
It is.
And it's back.
It's back,
and it's bigger.
It's bigger, I'm better. Yeah.
Yeah.
So I think we'll try and boot into the garage, and then we'll see
the
what cars have got on offer.
Yeah, so just briefly, we
I was
talk
watching
about the garage,
America's Test Kitchen. Yeah.
So the garage, we've got space for five cars in our
garage.
Hey,
broken canoe.
This time
or,
around,
yeah.
We've got a
Ben Kenobi
warehouse.
Says,
so
digging the up, up, down, down shirt.
Sure.
It would have been really awkward
cars.
If I had worn
so
mine as
bring
well.
Them in and out of your
I always keep it tight.
Work with the cars that you want to work with.
Cool.
You know
so
we're
you
both going to be wearing like that same shirt on the first day of Evo.
Oh, yeah.
So let's talk
no,
about
I'm
going to
get
cars.
A Bullet Club
so
shirt
we've got the
for,
BMW M4.
For Evo.
We had the
I'm going to get a Jinder Mahal shirt for Evo.
Okay.
There we go.
We've gone for the GTS. So it's a bit more track orientated. It's a
There's
bit
that
more,
one Bullet Club shirt that's Bullet Club cross
okay.
checking.
We got some muscle as well.
We've got some muscle cars. So last time around, we didn't really hit the money on the muscle cars. So yeah, we've done a bit more this time around.
And yeah, the Nissan 350Z, right? So everybody's been asking for it. We can't deny the fans what they want, so we've put it in Need for Speed.
Awesome.
And this one, yeah, it look, may look quirky, right?
Yeah.
It seems a bit out of place in Need for Speed, but what we've done is we've built this feature called the Derelict that, again, Marcus touched upon it in the live show, but
this is the
what the Derelict is a way for us to kind of...
Yeah.
Let
so these are those relics they were talking about.
Yep. Yeah.
Rich, you find a relic, you can...
Have,
so it's basically
so
the Forza barn. Forza, you know, Horizon barn.
So what's the... Don't hinder the gender. So what's the relic you guys want
to
find?
Scrap
because for me
car.
It's an old
cool.
80s Firebird.
So let's jump in the Beetle and fix it up a bit.
Yes, Kit, a Trans Am.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah,
right.
We want to restore it back to
whatever
yeah.
I can play as Knight
now,
Rider,
we should probably
I want that
say
option.
As well, these derelicts, you don't need to restore them like this.
You
can
you don't need to,
upgrade
no.
them a little bit. I think
absolutely.
We'll show that in a little bit.
Absolutely. And you could leave it like this.
Or the Mach 5.
Yeah, for sure. Not my particular style, but you know what I mean.
It might be somebody's style.
So yeah, you can see some
just
more of the
parts.
Just
the presentation definitely looks more like
Forza. So we've
Forza.
Tried to make sure
yeah.
that we've got parts in every
yeah.
interaction point that we have for this car. We want to make sure that we've got a rich experience wherever you go on the car. We've designed a lot of parts
find
for this
out
car
if WWE
as well because,
is
you know,
selling
out
a
there in
shirt,
reality,
no.
there's not that much that you can do for
I have
car,
to find
this
out.
Is Need for Speed, right? And we want to take it that extra step further.
Of course, of course. So we can play around with this car. Let's talk about some of the brands that are also a Need for Speed Payback.
Yeah, so we've not
I should do a special
any of the
stream
brands that
raise.
We had previously. So we've come back and we've got your Rocket
Beans,
we've got your Liberty Walks, we've got your Vortex
parts, we've got your APR parts,
we've got all these
rims.
Order,
so it could be anything.
So many rims.
It could be anything.
So we're all, we love that stuff. We want to bring that back to the people.
Of course. So I think we've done a pretty good job of showing this off. Shall we show off the big thing?
Yeah, so I talked about it previously. We want to take these cars to supercars.
The big
right?
thing?
So here we are, we've got our super builds. So these are effectively the biggest, the baddest, the
oh,
most
yes.
oh,
so these are
oriented
oh, okay.
build in Need for Speed.
Prototype.
Yeah, I've got my personal favorite down at the bottom.
Top
off-road.
Yeah,
off-road.
Drift
yeah.
build,
off-road.
Drag build, race
Jesus.
Build.
Need for Speed. And
that
yeah,
off-
is
oh
crazy.
My
we
goodness.
Wanted to build something special.
There you
yeah.
go,
and
that looks kind
of
cool.
My nips got hard.
Awesome.
My, my so, nips are not hard over Jinder Mahal's t-shirt. It's the modern day Maharaja.
So,
and
yeah,
it has a picture of a really badass elephant on it.
Sure
I don't
want to
wear this.
You want to put some time
but you do.
I want something that says don't hinder the gender.
Of course. Now, just while we have some extra time, let's talk about some of the stance tuning and stuff like that.
Stance tuning is back again.
30% off of
so
my order. That's like $6 off of my order.
Tweak them slightly, right? We wanted to
I'll
make sure
it.
That we could...
It's for watching the live stream of Dave. Check it out www.shop.com.
All right, we don't have to...
Looks crazy.
It's a bit of a...
So anyway, that is...
Yeah, what do we think about Need for Speed Payback now?
Yeah, we can kind of continue on.
Yeah, I think Need for Speed looks great, actually. I'm very...
This showed very well.
Very... intrigued by it, very pro Need for Speed. I there was
yeah.
a lot to like in the first one, a lot not to like with it as well, but this one looks like again it's just going to improve on all of those elements and offer something just really over the top.
Yep.
Yeah and it kind of, you know, it was that gameplay mixed with the CG footage. Like it was tough to tell what's what. It looks really nice.
Mm-hmm. So after Need for Speed, they talked about their Indies initiative. And...
Oh, and if you wanted to back up just a second, we don't need to talk about it, but there was FIFA in between Battlefield and Need for Speed.
We had 80 minutes of
yeah,
FIFA.
FIFA was almost as big as Battlefront.
Right. I don't really know that I want to mention much about it.
How excited are you? How excited are you about FIFA?
Not at all.
Next. How about you? All right, there we go.
I'll play that, it.
Done.
when it gets into EA Access, they can play it in the vault for free. Then I'll care.
Yeah.
But. So back to the EA Originals. No fee, no fay.
No fee, no fay. But we got the new game from the producers of Brothers, A Tale of Two Sons. Light.
Yeah, let's get into this. Yeah, the Hazelight Studio is making a way out.
Yep.
This I'm hyped and bummed. Yeah, go ahead.
I wrote down three notes. It's a mixture of Prison Break, Uncharted, and Army of Two.
Maybe. I don't know. I'm really high on the game. Bless you.
I am too. I'm very high on this game. This might be a game that I would, if you have to. So it's multiplayer only, no single player from what I'm gathering.
That's a bummer.
And you can play online with someone else, but to get the full feel, they said you should sit next to someone and play on the couch.
I get what they're going for. It's a unique concept, and when put into play, it looks like it'd be very interesting. But so basically, after a certain time of day, I can't play this game.
Well, not necessarily. You can find somebody online. You can find a stranger.
Sure.
Well, if it's midnight, I'll play a way out. Oh wait, I can't.
Somebody in Europe might be playing. I don't know.
Right. Dave, I'll play this game with you.
All right. It looks like the problem I would see would be it looks like it's just a one playthrough experience.
So. Right. Because he said something about when you get through this, it's going to be nothing like nothing you ever played before. But when it's done. Like, what's going to make me come back to it?
Yeah.
It was different ways of solving the same puzzles.
I was going to say, yeah, there are different ways of solving puzzles than probably. I'm looking at the stream. There's a giant mech in the background. So there's Respawn for you.
Yeah, they're outside as well.
Yeah.
Let us in.
I personally could see myself playing through this game with my buddy Sean, who kind of likes these indie titles. these different experiences. He's not like the AAA type of dude. So that's what excited me about the game. I could actually see the scenario in which I would play this game. Some dude's just walking up to one of the hosts. That's hilarious. He's like, get out of here. What the hell?
I assume they
knew him. One of the stars, Devin Wade.
Devin in the Flash.
Alongside himself. Thank
you for having me. He's the guy for Madden. He's the lead guy in
the Madden story guy.
Oh, that's funny. Anyway, I could see scenarios in which I would be playing and enjoying that game. I think it looks very very neat. I keep using intriguing, but it does look very intriguing. I'm very interested in the game and I would like to play it.
Yeah.
So after that, what did we... Oh, the other thing that I was going to say about that game. So you got two characters, Vincent and Leo. Yes. One thing that I'm really hoping for is a sideburn growing minigame. That's the one thing that will sell me 100% on that game is sideburn growing minigame.
Yep. Let me grow sideburns.
Yeah. What else... another thing that I thought was really interesting was that... The game continues on. It's not just them getting out of prison, but it's also them staying out of prison and them picking up and doing things in their lives after prison.
Right.
And continuing on. So that is really interesting because a game like that, the temptation for a developer would be just to make the whole focus about how do we get out of jail.
Right.
So I think that's taking a very big risk. One that I think could really pay off in a meaningful way, the fact that it's not just limited to them getting out of prison. So,
yeah, the prison aspect seems like I don't want to say afterthought, but it's just kind of the beginning of the much larger story.
Yeah,
sure.
Could this be the gaming equivalent of the Shawshank Redemption?
I think somebody in chat was saying that was the vibe they were getting off that. Well,
so yeah. after that. EA went on to talk about Seed, their search for Extraordinary Experiences Division. Now, they really didn't talk much about what this was all about. It seems like it could be anything from finding new technology to finding a great salsa.
Yeah.
I really
salsa.
I love salsa as well. Finding the
oh my god, that's scary as hell, Dan Marino.
Finding the perfect barbecue sauce. It could be any one of those things.
Yeah, they didn't really go into too much detail.
Yeah. Yeah. And I'd like to know a little bit more about how is this different than your Indies initiative? How are those working in tandem? Why is this being talked about
on stage at E3?
And they didn't show much when it came to the Indies either. They just showed the one game, so.
Yeah, yeah. I love how he said, we have all these games we're working on. Here's one.
Yeah, they always focus on just one throughout the year. All right, so after that little tease, we got another
little tease. My favorite
moment.
Oh, this is going to be
But
great.
It was the big tease.
Yep.
BioWare's new IP. So it's called Anthem. They're going to talk a bit about it tomorrow at Microsoft's Xbox One conference. They'll talk about it during the Scorpio presentation.
They just bought Impact Wrestling. Oh, wait, sorry.
Wrong anthem.
All we know is that it's futuristic. It has something to do with a society maybe built behind this wall. Yep. And it's protecting them. What is the tagline? The wall protects us from what lies beyond. So, very cool.
This seems cool. I'm way into this. This seems like maybe post-apocalyptic, with future tech. This seems kind of cool.
Yeah, it could go anywhere, really.
Well, and I wrote down a note that it. Even the visor from like the character that they showed, one of the, you know, I guess would be soldiers or whatever it was, kind of almost looked Titanfall-esque. Even some of the creatures in the world, you know, the one monster they showed kind of from the side had a Titanfall-esque monster feel. I don't think it necessarily has anything to do with Titanfall, but it looked really cool. And I'm very intrigued by what they showed.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, we'll find.
What is the screen?
They're just showing like people getting like their faces marked from mocap.
Chad Ochocinco back there. Oh my gosh. Anyway.
So we'll find out more at tomorrow's Xbox event, which kicks off, I believe, at 4 o'clock. If I'm not mistaken.
Could this be their big like exclusive deal that they were talking about?
That could be.
Yeah.
That would be.
It makes more sense than Half-Life 3.
But here's my question, though. With BioWare, you know, we were just talking about the shortcomings of Mass Effect Andromeda and Dragon Age. Does this intrigue you enough to stay tuned and maybe jump into Anthem?
Yes, because it's a new IP. I think without any sort of, pre-existing notion of what to expect. You know, I have no expectations for this except, hey, it's a BioWare game, which means I'll give it a shot, here's my money. I think this is the right call to go away from what they've been doing and work on something new, and this intrigues me.
Yeah, right.
BioWare has stumbled so much in their previous few efforts, they got to prove it to me with this game. I'm not sold on the BioWare name alone.
Right, I agree.
But we'll find out more tomorrow. So
yes, yep. Yeah, this is all just a here. Look at this.
I'm so intrigued. Come back tomorrow. I hope we see so much more tomorrow because I'm really intrigued by this.
Yes.
Yep.
So from there we go to Resurrection of Lazarus proportions, NBA Live 2018.
Yep.
Yet another sports game getting a single player story driven mode called The One. Which is an authentic NBA experience. He goes and plays basketball in the streets, yada yada.
I just think this seems like, hey, whatever you do in any mode matters. I think that's the whole basis of whether you're playing in like your career mode and the actual association, or if you're playing online with the pro-am stuff, it all will tie into the same thing. I think that's basically all that is.
In the Drew League.
Sorry.
In the Drew League.
I'm going to start the Jeff League here pretty soon.
I want a Drew League t-shirt now.
Man. Oh, man. Yeah, if it was me, I think we all are on the same page as this. Basketball games are basketball games. 2K is still going to run the world on this one. How many times can they resurrect this and get it wrong? So give us NBA Street. Let us play the streets that way. So
yeah.
Yeah, they've got to do so much for them to be on a competitive level against, and it's not enough for them to just put out a decent game like Star Wars Battlefront, you know, where there are still some issues with it and some things that they could do better, and then they can do better next year. They've got to put out what they're doing with Battlefront 2 this year, basically.
Right.
With NBA Live 2018. It's got to be a top-notch effort just to get their foot in the door so they can put out an NBA Live 19 next year.
Right.
Right.
So I hope they're up for the task. Competition is always a good thing, but
yes,
again, I'm not sold on it considering their past efforts.
Or, damn it, just make a new NBA Jam. Like, it's been, what, 09?
It's time.
2010 was the last NBA Jam they put out, and it was a great version of that game. Update the rosters, put out a new NBA Jam, and call it good. And I'm not saying every year of Jam, but every 2-3 years, a new Jam game.
So, any last thoughts on NBA Live?
I'm sure I'll play it. I mean, yeah. it's easier for me to say, yeah, I'll play it, because I've been working in, you know, basketball and in professional basketball for almost a decade now.
Wow.
So, you know, basketball is always kind of, I mean, I'm a hockey guy first and foremost, and yes, I'm a Pittsburgh Penguins fan, so everyone just shut up. One more win. But, you know, basketball has been something that's been a part of my life for a long time. So, yeah, I'll play it. I won't pay $60 for it. But
are they going to a game 7?
Yeah. Well, no, they're going to game 6. Which game 6 is tomorrow in Nashville.
What time?
I'll be doing this while also keeping an eye on
the Penguins game. Dude. Oh, my God.
It'll go to 7.
That's dedication there. Sorry,
hey,
Justin.
Hey, I watched the Cubs win the World Series at Principal Park. So, I'll be, you know, diehard fan.
That's all right. I remember covering Sony's E3 event a couple of years ago, and then having to switch really quick to the Blackhawks winning the Stanley Cup.
Right.
They won that game. Anyway. Yeah. All right. So after NBA Live came the big one, the main event, ladies and gentlemen, Star Wars Battlefront 2.
How were we thinking before during our prediction show? Which you can find at the Jeff Ball Games YouTube channel and the Nerd Bacon stuff as well. Compared from that to how we feel now, what has changed and what has stayed the same? I'm more hyped. I feel like this thing sold it for me.
Yeah, definitely more hyped on Star Wars Battlefront 2. I don't know if it's quite at the level of day one-ing for me, but it's getting close.
It's really close for a day one purchase for me as well. And I think most of us put EA almost at the end of our, like, hey, what we're most excited for. They did a little better than I thought they did. They didn't really have any moments that I felt like lagged. Everything they showed looked really good. So,
it was kind of weird pacing in this overall.
Yeah.
The seed stuff, I confused me more than anything. And then, I don't know why you have to have all these stormtroopers and stuff come out. Just go with Star Wars, you know.
Well, they had a good host for the Star Wars part, so.
Yeah, definitely.
Confusing at first, but I'm like, okay.
I hope they bring her back and she just takes over as the official host for EA.
That would be cool. I'm okay with that.
Anyway, so any final thoughts on Star Wars Battlefront? I know we talked a lot about it during the 30-minute gameplay demo that they ran.
This just looks like what we wanted first and foremost. It looks like they took what they learned from the first Battlefront game and said, and I like that they came out and acknowledged it right away. So, okay, you know, all these tweets saying how bummed they were is, okay, we see you, we know what's going on. Here's the new product. We take out all into consideration. They're presenting this the right way, and I'm very, very hyped for this thing now.
Yeah, they during the show basically ate a big slice of humble pie. They made sure that they let us know, like, hey, we listened to you guys, we heard what you had to say, and this is what we're gonna do to fix it, and that's what we as fans want to hear. So,
good on them.
Yeah. You know, it's everything I wrote down. It says more everything. Gear, guns, maps. You know, everything looks fantastic. Everything's bigger. Everything's supposed to be better. More heroes. They're combining all three eras.
Let's talk about gears, guns, and maps just for a second. How awesome is it that all of this extra DLC content is going to be free, guys?
Free.
Holy shit.
It kind of confused me at first because they first DLC is free. That'll have Finn, Captain Phasma and some other stuff. But then they're like, oh, by the way, all the other DLC is free.
Yeah,
I'm like, okay,
that's
you got
major
my attention.
League.
Yeah, that was kind of piggybacking the rumor that had leaked saying that there'd be no season pass, and it sounds like that's actually the case.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. I imagine you'll have to pay money for something. I mean, they can't just sit there and not make more money when it's basically a cash cow when if they play it right. But I imagine they'll all be cosmetic stuff because, again, Titanfall 2 has the same thing where the DLC is free, but you can, I believe you can pump money into it. I think that's a smart move with a game that needed a kind of a refresh in people's minds.
Right.
Sure. Well, maybe they'll take the Halo 5 route with this. Maybe all the DLC is free. You can unlock certain DLC or you can buy. I mean, or maybe, like you said, just DLC. Here it is for free. We'll give you all this. It's free DLC. And then, you know, if you want the cosmetic stuff, the different shaders, whatever else, you can buy it. So some sort of small microtransaction.
Right on. And I would be fine with that. I'd be fine with small cosmetic microtransactions,
sure.
Especially if they give you the opportunity to buy the dress that the hostess was wearing.
It's a cool dress. If they take the Overwatch kind of aspect of that, where we can give you these little loot boxes at every level, or if you want to pump some money into it, you can get some right now.
Mm-hmm.
But taking that round, and hey, if you want this gear right now, give us, you know, you can give us some money for a chance to get that.
Sure.
Or, you know, it this makes sense.
Yeah. You know, and the only other thing I'll say about Battlefront is it did feel like they were maybe pushing a little bit towards the e-sports side of things. But it didn't feel like it was too over the top. Everything felt really organic, it looked cool. The dog fights looked fantastic. The heroes looked fantastic.
I'd be okay with the esports because I love dumb things, and there are dumb things that happen in every Battlefront and Battlefield game.
Right.
Yes. Yes. I agree.
So I guess that about wraps everything up. EA kind of closed out with Battlefront. Any last thoughts on Battlefront or just EA's event as a whole? I thought it was a pretty zippy event. I thought there were some pretty cool things about it. It was about what we expected.
Yeah.
Really no big surprises. The other Star Wars games that have been talked about and rumored, those were not talked about.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of right where we were expecting there.
Yeah, it's exactly what I was thinking would happen as far as the big stuff. Nothing came out and surprised. It was, again, it was they didn't go too stupid. They didn't go too safe. They just stayed the course, and that's all I really wanted from me from EA.
Yeah. Well, and for me, the only things that I noted that I felt like they didn't touch on or they missed, obviously we mentioned no Titanfall, but I think that series might be on its last leg at this point. And
Titanfall
then,
2 is still good.
It's still such a good game. If you haven't played it, you should. No PopCap. They didn't talk about anything. Plants vs. Zombies.
That's good.
And, you know, the Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare games are great. Those are actually fun and stupid fun to play.
Yes.
But no mention of anything there. And then no mention of NHL.
Yeah.
That was disappointing. No mention
Which
of NHL.
I was disappointed in, especially with it being in the finals right now.
Yeah,
I figured there'd be some sort of mention of the NHL, but there was nothing there. So
they had all that room for NBA Live. You know, they needed to make sure to not put anything else in there.
They spent way too much. That's the only my only downfall is they spent more time on NBA Live than they should have.
And it wasn't long, but
right.
It was
kind of a big deal though because it is the relaunch of a franchise.
Right. Yep. Right.
I don't know. I would have liked to have seen some NHL. I was also surprised that there was no mention of Mass Effect Andromeda DLC.
That's right. No Mass Effect.
Yeah, they may just be kind of backing off and letting time heal some wounds, I guess, on that. But who knows? BioWare had a bigger thing up their sleeve, and it was Anthem.
Anthem, I don't know what it is. I don't know what to expect, but I am certainly intrigued.
We'll find out more at the first show tomorrow. With Microsoft kicking off, what time did you have it up on the screen?
Looks like our pre-show will kick off at 4 p.m. Eastern, so that'll be 3 o'clock Central, and then we'll go for an hour, a whole bloody hour, talking about what we're expecting, hoping, dreaming, praying for Microsoft. And then we'll go right in and offer our commentary live during Microsoft's E3 event, which is supposed to be over an hour and a half long.
Yeah.
And of course, our examination afterwards. So you will not want to miss that. Tune right in. Give us a follow right here on Twitch. You can also follow us, Jeff of All Games. That is his channel. We also do a podcast each and every week, the Level Up Lariat Show. You can find that on YouTube under Jeff of All Games and sometimes broadcast right here on Nerd Bacon. But be sure, whatever you do, come back tomorrow, 4 o'clock Eastern, 3 Central, as we prepare to cover Microsoft and the unveiling of the Scorpio. Justin, thank you very much for joining us. We will see you tomorrow. Jeff, thank you very much. We'll see you tomorrow.
Indeed.
And everybody else at Nerd Bacon, we will see you tomorrow. Thanks, everyone, for joining us. Have a good night, everyone.
Later.
Thank you.